The man seen in this terrifying video, obtained by TMZ, pulling a pistol from his waistband and firing toward the crowded baggage claim at Fort Lauderdale's airport, is now charged with 3 federal crimes, 2 of which carry a possible death penalty. 5 people were killed in that violent attack on Friday. In court, 26-year-old Esteban Santiago told the judge he was currently unemployed and only has $5 to $10 to his name. He added that he had previously worked as a security officer and served about a decade in the Army. His family telling CNN that his personality had changed dramatically after his last deployment to Iraq. All this as new questions emerge regarding Santiago's mental health and just how he was able to gain access to the weapon used in the deadly airport massacre.
There was no escape. I just began to prayed that my children wouldn't lose their mother.
Police say this 9mm handgun had been confiscated from the shooter in November after he walked into an FBI office in Alaska to tell them he was hearing voices and was being influenced by ISIS. But after a mental health evaluation, he was not deemed mentally defective. The gun was returned.
How is that possible? Well, under existing law, mental illness can only be grounds to take away somebody's weapons if a court has ordered you involuntarily committed to a mental hospital. If you're merely surrendering voluntarily, that does not deprive you of the right to have weapons.
It's a loophole that baffles Santiago's own family.
How are you going to let someone leave a psychological center after 4 days when he is saying that he's hearing voices?
Court documents show Santiago has confessed to planning the attack. Friends and associates noticed more erratic behavior, investigators say, all leading up to Friday, when he fired approximately 10 to 15 rounds, aiming at his victims' heads.
One of the ladies that was killed was my seatmate on the plane. Her husband was shot in the face. The guy next to him was shot in the cheek.
Families of the victims are now providing images of their loved ones killed in the attack, including mothers, fathers, and grandparents. Those left behind, no doubt wondering how things could have been different.